What is up you guys, Mr. Foolstroke back with another video from Bangalore, and I hope the audio and everything is coming out just fine because it's my test with my external mic. And as you can see, we are in somewhere in Bangalore, and what I have with me today is the 2017 model, but nonetheless it's a KTM Duke 200, and I have it for a test ride review, and we'll see how this bike performs. So okay, we'll wait for it to pass. So what I have is the 2017 Duke 200, so we can do nothing but start this first ride review. Okay, let me get on this motorcycle. And big shout out to my friend Santosh. He's a good friend of mine, and he gave me this bike for a review. So as you can see, there are no mirrors and everything, and this bike comes with basically no electronics or anything whatsoever, not even ABS. So what I have right here is basically the 2017. I seriously doubt this is a 2017 model, because the stickering on the side definitely looks like it's a 2017 model, but it doesn't. You know, the auto headlamp on feature is kind of not available in this thing. So okay, we'll start this thing. So without boring you any further with the technical specifications and stuff, I'll put it on the screen right here so you can see what the power and torque figures and everything are. So let's get started. Sounds pretty nasty, man. Okay. As you would expect from a 200cc fuel injected motorcycle, the power and everything seems pretty adequate. Let's test out the power first now, shall we? Here it goes. So I redlined it and it went to almost 60 in the third gear. That's the amount of vicious power that this KTM Duke 200 unleashes, and my god, what an engine braking. Another thing which I'll say just now, which I just noticed, is that this is probably one of the most hardest seats I've ever sat on, because when I just ripped the bike in third gear and it went to almost 60 kmph, and when I let go of the clutch, the engine braking literally made me slide in the front. So that is not that great. I mean, I think KTM really needs to work on, you know, making their seats a bit more cushioned, so you know, rider also feels a bit of comfort. So let's get straight into the point. Talking about ergonomics, I'm sitting fairly upright, and it's kind of like the ideal street naked posture, you know. So that's how it is. So comfort wise, this bike I would give it, you know, like 6 out of 10 or something. Man, what a bike. I mean, this bike is definitely, as you can see by the looks as well, when you're sitting completely upright, this bike is not meant for any sort of, you know, cornering or track riding or whatever. But given that it comes with a very sticky MRF tires, you know, which are mediatorly soft compound and everything, you can use this bike on the track, because obviously KTM encourages it to use, you know, on the track and stuff with the KTM track day and all that. So you can use it on the track. Okay, let's rip it one more time. This bike is fast. I mean, fifth gear, I started from somewhere around and one more thing which the KTM has, which I really like, is that it has a gear positioning indicator. Means it tells you which gear the engine is engaged in currently. That's very good. I mean, for people who are learning how to ride and have Duke 200 as their first motorcycle, this will definitely help, because while learning, obviously a lot of people forget as to which gear their bike is in. So this will definitely help. I just went at 80 kmph, and I gotta say, the bike didn't feel stressed at all. talking about power figures and everything, I think it fares up pretty decently among the other 200cc fuel injected motorcycles, like, you know, the Pulsar RS200 and the KTM RC200, which is its full fate sibling. So everything on that sort fronts and fits really well. But, you know, in some aspects, I think the KTM 200, you can definitely do way better than the competition. Considering, you know, people always considered Pulsar 200 NS to be the competitor of this motorcycle, and I think the 200 Duke definitely fares up better than, look at these squids, man, look at these dumbass squids. No gears, shitty haircuts, they're riding scooters. Call life. One thing I really want to say is that, you know, the gear shifts on this bike is really, really clunky. I mean, the gear shifts are way more harder than it should be. Now, it might be the case with this particular Duke 200 itself, but I've seen on many other Duke 200s that, you know, a lot of my friends have the Duke 200 and they say that, you know, the gear shifts and everything are very clunky and not that great as they expect it to be. That's kind of disappointing, really, to be honest, because for a bike that can stay stable at 80 or 100 and, you know, doing triple digit speeds is absolutely a piece of cake on this bike, I think the gear shifts and everything should be a little more smooth to, you know, enhance the ride quality and everything. I'm not saying this might be the case with every Duke 200, but, you know, this bike in particular with what I have right here might have it, because there might be a case that this bike might not be that well maintained. And I'm completely scared to take any turns since this bike doesn't have a rear view mirrors. Mind you guys, I don't own this motorcycle, my friend does, and he has opted to take out the mirrors from the motorcycle, so it looks like I can't really help it. Oh, Bullet Desert Storm 500. One other thing which you'll obviously notice while riding this motorcycle is that since this is a naked motorcycle, and obviously when you do high speeds, like, you know, 80 or triple digit speeds or something, obviously you'll feel a lot of wind blast coming your way, because this is a naked bike, it doesn't have a visor in the front, and obviously, you know, it's not meant to be so aerodynamic that it'll just cut through air and stuff. So okay, let's rip it. I'm sure. So my experience of riding this motorcycle so far has been that the seating posture is comfortable, but there should be a lot more cushion in the seat to make it more comfortable than it is right now. And this comes with sticky MRF tires, so you can definitely use it on the track day and stuff if you want. And KTM, if you're listening to this, you really need to, you know, put your bike and make it equipped with ABS and stuff, because since this is one of the most affordable and powerful 200cc motorcycles out there in the market, you know, with comes with fuel injection and brand like KTM, which is very popular, I think putting ABS would make this bike all the more safer for the younger generation and people who are learning how to ride. But I gotta say, man, the feel of the non-ABS front brake is definitely way more and way better than the ABS front brake, because the feel of you directly hitting the brakes and, you know, the rotors directly coming in contact with, you know, you can actually feel the brake pads and everything coming in directly in contact with the rotor disc. So that feel is definitely way more better than, you know, an ABS, which is intrusive, and definitely it is a good feature, but KTM should definitely include this, you know, at least the switchable ABS, if nothing else. Man, filtering this bike around is such a piece of cake, because, man, I gotta say, this bike is insanely light for a 200cc motorcycle. I mean, I have ridden an RS200 and made a review about it, which you can watch by, you know, clicking the link in the description box. So I'll put that link. And this bike is definitely way more lighter than a RS200. So people who want to go for the Duke 200, definitely go for it. But I would suggest is try the Duke 250, which is, like, you know, everything the Duke 200 has with a 50 more cc and a little more power and torque, and it basically gets a completely new design. So people who want to opt for the Duke 200, I think you can go for it if your budget is you know, at the par with the cost of the Duke 200. If it's a little bit more, I suggest you go for the KTM Duke 250. because that is like, you know, the perfect street naked is what I'd call it. I know we have 390 and stuff, but I think 44 BHP is a little bit of an overkill considering, you know, the kind of shitty traffic I'm stuck at right now. So this comes with, I think, a 300mm front disc with steel braided lines, and a rear disc is I think a 230 or 240mm, I don't know, I'll probably put it up on the screen right here. And you know, there have always been issues of, you know, the KTM's rims not being that strong as compared to, you know, other motorcycles, because obviously, man, these bikes are meant to be made lighter, so you can obviously flick it around in the traffic and stuff. Even the KTM RC, man, that's supposed to go fast on the track, and that's why the fuel capacity and everything has been decreased. Taking this thing, man, I think this holds about 12 or 11 liters or something, which, you know, usable fuel is only about 10 liters, so that's kind of not good. And I would easily recommend KTM to, you know, increase the fuel size just a bit, because even with the fuel full tank, you know, you'll be getting a fuel economy of somewhere around I think 30 to 35 kmpl with your riding style, if you ride this bike sensibly in, you know, mixed riding conditions and stuff. I must say, man, I'm thoroughly enjoying this bike right now. So this is basically the same as everything with the, you know, the usual Duke, except that, you know, 2017 Duke gets a bigger disc and auto headlamp on feature, a BS4 engine, and basically nothing has changed. It still gets the same underbelly exhaust as before, and I gotta say, man, this bike sounds pretty mean. Man, I really hate this. I mean, the brake lever and the gear shift lever are completely, you know, on the upper side. I mean, yeah, it does make for a better upshifts, but when you have to, you know, be in traffic and you have to constantly upshift and downshift, the upper part of your feet will start getting hurt after some time, because you have to continuously stretch your leg up front. And man, people, KTM, I think there are adjustable levers, that's what I think. My Apache has an adjustable lever, so if it doesn't fit your liking, you can obviously adjust the position of that. The thing which makes the fuel injected motorcycles way better than the carbureted motorcycle is that, you know, after a certain RPM range, the carbureted motorcycle starts running out of juice. That is not the case with the fuel injected motorcycles, because no matter which RPM range you're in, you know, the torque is spread evenly everywhere, and as you rev the bike higher and higher, the bike pulls more. So yeah, riding this bike around for almost half an hour right now, and I gotta say, man, this first ride experience has been epic so far. So I think that was it about my first ride review, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you soon in the next video. So take care, bye bye, and over and out.